My name is Mitchell Elegbe and I'm CEO at Interswitch. My role as CEO primarily is to ensure that there's trust within the organization and that our external customers also trust the organization. And in doing that, there are various tools at my disposal. I think one that resonates with me a lot is a definition of leadership that I learned many years ago, which basically says that leadership is built on two pillars, the ability to organize and the ability to motivate. But one very critical part of leadership is motivation, which is your ability to free people to do willingly and well whatever needs to be done. And what that basically means is that you have to create a very compelling vision for the organization, a vision that your colleagues buy into, a vision that basically gives them a reason to want to be part of the organization and go after the objectives of the organization. Once that is done, the next step is how do I free them to willingly do whatever is required to achieve that vision, whether you are there or you are not there. We saw the challenges in the environment, we saw the social problems with cash, and all we need to do was to look for ways to solve that. Of course, you need to have some credibility. So one of the ways we achieved this was to ensure that initially some of our strategic stakeholders, the banks in this case, were actually owners of the business. And so they were on the board, they could see where the company was going, they took part in all of the decisions that we made, and that helped a lot. So having established credibility, the next question is how do you begin to establish the business and grow the business? There was nowhere to go to for talent. We're basically starting this from scratch. So we basically had to build the skills in-house, lots of training, get people to believe in that vision, okay? Getting them to want to actually do things and see things happen. Once that was done, the next challenge is how do you keep these people? While we have built a lot of skills, we've also lost a lot of skills who are in different organizations adding value also. So the ability to build talent, skills, the ability to retain them is one of the challenges that we have had to deal with. Over time, we've also dealt with the issue of fraud. Payment is a business that most people are interested in, especially fraudsters. And so they continue to try different things. And as you know, fraud, electronic fraud is organized business globally. So these guys have access to resources that traditionally you'd be shocked that they have access to. So as a company in this environment, one of the things you need to do is basically to keep up increasing your standards to ensure that you are able to ward off some of these basic issues. So I think the first thing to understand is that the business we are in as payment is one that evolves rapidly. Customer requirements are changing. And like you already said, technology is evolving also. And so the tools you have at your disposal to address the challenges that customers face keep changing. I think one way to look at that is to ensure that your organization has been built in a way that it can respond to change. Having the right kind of structure helps a lot. You need a structure that allows you to respond in three different ways in real time, okay? One, a structure that allows you to respond to changes in customer requirements or demands. A culture or a structure that allows you to respond to the changes in technology itself. And for a regulated business, a structure also that allows you to respond to whatever new directions the regulator puts in place, and I think that has really helped. The challenge we're trying to solve was not a payment problem, it was a social problem. It did not make sense that many years ago, people would go to the banks and queue up and have tally numbers. It did not make sense to us that if your staff tell you by lunchtime on Friday that they are going to the bank, they may never come back. And the excuse has always been there was a long queue. It did not make sense at that point in time that when you go check statistics of armed robberies, it's usually very high on Fridays and Saturdays. It did not make sense that if you're on your way home in traffic and you're attacked, there's a high likelihood that those hoodlums will find cash on you. So there's a lot of people thinking about cash therefore as a problem. And they felt the need was to eliminate cash. But the approach we looked at Interswitch there was that we saw cash as a social problem, but the solution was not to eliminate it. The solution was to make cash available just in time. In other words, do not stockpile cash if you know you can get it just where you need it. Today, we are being challenged by other areas in Nigeria today and on the continent where we feel we can easily apply technology to. Take healthcare. Very disorganized, like it was in banking many years ago. Lots of players, lots of inconvenience for people. Healthcare is one area that Interswitch is really passionate about, and we're already looking at it on how to deal with that. Another area that we're passionate about is transportation. There could be a more modern, what we call a multimodal, multi-operator approach to transport. But the fact remains that we have the DNA to use technology to basically address problems or challenges in the markets, in the environment, one step at a time. There are different definitions of entrepreneurs, but one that resonates with me a lot is a definition I talked about. For you to be an entrepreneur, you basically have an idea, but you have no resources whatsoever to bring your idea to fruition. And the way the world has been created, the people that have the resources sometimes are not the ones that have the ideas. So ideas, good ideas need to meet with good resources for there to be that kind of fusion to make this happen. Why did I choose to go to LBS? Coming out of school and working for some time and having the opportunity, I could see that it was time to set up Interswitch, and I was going to be getting the responsibility of running the business. And this was barely 3 years after NYC. The first question that came to your mind is, am I competent? So I needed a place to check and test my idea. I think the first thing to understand is that the business we are in as payment is one that evolves rapidly. Technology is evolving also. And so the tools you have at your disposal to address the challenges that customers face keep changing. I think one way to look at that is to ensure that your organization has been built in a way that it can respond to change. And the way the world has been created, the people that have the resources sometimes are not the ones that have the ideas. So ideas, good ideas need to meet with good resources for there to be that kind of fusion to make this happen. It's right to say that Interswitch has asked the right question over time, and the market has rewarded us for asking the right question and putting the right solutions in place.